طيب، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome students to lecture number 2 for the microprocessor and assembly language. This lecture is now recorded. I already have posted to the Blackboard the video of the first lecture, and after every lecture, inshallah, we will be posting the lecture on the subdirectory called the videos of the lectures. Today we want to continue with the introduction. In the last lecture, we put a definition for the microprocessor, and today we want to continue with this definition, explaining its terms to understand what is the microprocessor. So in the first set of the slides for the introduction, we are actually describing a lot and defining a lot of new terms. The terms may be you may be familiar with those terms, however here we want to guarantee that you really understand them. This is one thing. The other thing is that the terms may have some confusing meaning, and we want to do our best to clarify what do we mean by those terms. These are the basics for what we will be following, inshallah, in the rest of the class. So in the last lecture, we have actually explained a little bit the special feature of the microprocessor. Other than any digital logic circuit, this unique feature is the programmability of the microprocessor. This is what makes it a unique device. Okay. Right. In the last lecture, we finished till slide number 9. Okay. I'm not sure if you prefer for me to show the word or show the slides, and you can follow the slides during my talk. I'm not sure what you prefer. So let's do something, maybe mixing between those two. I have some text here and some students putting comments. Okay. Yeah. People say yes, please. Please means showing the slides or showing the board. You need both. The slides. Okay. Okay. Come on. Fine. If we have a lot of demonstration on the board, I will make the screen of the board enlarge it. Okay. The first set of the slides for the introduction, most of the discussion is in definitions. So let's show the slides. However, I want you to also be ready with the slide with you. Open it on your screen. This may be also helpful. Okay. And I can simply narrate the slide number. However, let's stick to what is you prefer for now, which is actually showing Mimba, showing a small screen of the board until we have a very big demonstration, something that is needs really explanation, and then we will go back to a full screen for the board. Tamam? Time. So, going back to the definition of the microprocessor. Microprocessor is a programmable. Can you see my screen now? Can you see the slides? Okay, great. Perfect. Now, we will demonstrate on the slides until we have really have something critical to put it on the board. I will enlarge the board, okay, and my picture. Right. The microprocessor is a programmable device that takes in numbers, perform on them arithmetic and logic operations according to the program stored in the memory, and then produce numbers as the result. Definitely, not everything that the human being is dealing with are numbers, and not every output that the human being is seeking from the computer system are numbers. But we will see how everything will be translated, converted into numbers in order to make them ready and available for the microprocessor to process. And this is maybe a catch, important catch, and an important thing that is a little bit trickier. But now, we talk about the programmability. Programmability means I have a set of, so we need to discriminate between the word. We have a word called instruction, and we have what's called a program. Program is a set of instructions, a group of instructions building a full program or a full code for a program. Okay, the instruction is the most elementary element or entry that the microprocessor can understand. If each microprocessor is designed with a set of instructions that this microprocessor could comprehend and understand, okay, which we call them the instruction set. Okay, so the microprocessor designers, when design the microprocessor, they do what's called ISA. Instruction, ISA stands for instruction set architecture. Okay, so there are multiple designs for the instruction set. What's the instruction set? The instruction set is the set of instructions that the microprocessor understands. Like what? Like add, subtract, move, divide, rotate, copy, okay, input data, output data, okay, jump to some location, shift left, shift right, good answer, ma'am. If all of those are instructions, the microprocessor understands set of instructions based on its design. Designers who will design the microprocessor also need to design for the microprocessor the ISA, instruction set. Instruction set means a set of instructions, MacMorric instruction. Instruction set A, architecture. Why we call it architecture? Because I can design the instruction set in many different ways. Okay? If we are interested to learn different instruction set architectures, we could just go and Google or go to the Wikipedia and write this name. You will find plenty of instruction set ISAs, instruction set architecture. Each company designing a microprocessor has its own instruction set architecture. Okay, these instruction set architectures are the set of instructions that the microprocessor can understand, can comprehend, and can execute. ماشي. Okay, شباب. طيب جميل. Okay, so before we go talking more about the software side and how the microprocessor deal with the instructions and deal with the programs, we need to get some information about how the microprocessor is designed and how the microprocessor hardware is being built. Yes, the instruction set architecture depends on the the microprocessor family. We have two families of microprocessor. Let us defer this to next lecture. Today we want to put the software and the instruction set architecture aside, and we wanted to talk about more about the details of the hardware of the microprocessor. Okay, what is the microprocessor and what's the idea of the microprocessor that make it this unique device that is a programmable and can reach a programmable? Okay, so we need to first understand the microprocessor is not just one piece of hardware. Okay, inside the microprocessor it contains a group of blocks. Okay, the most important block of the microprocessor is what's called the arithmetic and logic unit, ALU, perfect hint. Okay, دي بقى البرين of the brain. يعني ايه البرين of the brain؟ المايكروبروسيسور is the brain of your computer. And the brain of the microprocessor is the ALU. What is the ALU? ALU is a group of arithmetic and logic units. ALU, U stands for units that can perform arithmetic and logic operations. تمام كده؟ طيب ايه يبقى ايه طب what's the difference between the operation and the instruction? Okay, so far there is no difference. يبقى احنا we can use the word instruction and the word operation interchangeably so far. Okay, we cannot discriminate between them. يبقى الoperation يبقى each operation inside the ALU should reflect on the instruction. يعني if you have a microprocessor that has an adder, that means I have to see and add, that means that the microprocessor can do add operation. Accordingly, I have to have add instruction. This microprocessor can do divide operation. That means it has divide unit in hardware. And so the divide unit can do divide operation. Accordingly, I should see in the ISA a divide instruction. Agree? Make sense so far? طيب. ها؟ جميل. طيب. يبقى I think the basic definition of the microprocessor is now clear. Okay? It is actually a machine that has some brain, some ALU, some arithmetic and logic units, and you know how to build those units from VLD. We will add or subtract or multiplier. Okay, if that time allows us, we may build also a divider, okay, a comparator. All of those together we call them the arithmetic and logic unit. العقل المدبر داخل المايكروبروسيسور. These actually components has the job to do the operation, the real brain that actually perform the arithmetic and the logic operations. Right. يبقى المايكروبروسيسور is taking the input data, okay, through the memory, it can have a program stored and it will execute the instructions to produce the output data of the end user. You change the program in the memory, that means you will perform a different task or a different program in the microprocessor. And this makes it programmable. That means if I'm changing my program, I can use the microprocessor in different tasks. عايز العب جيم هحط البروجرام بتاع الجيم في الميموري والمايكروبروسيسور هينفذه لي. We will execute it. I wanted to do browsing, searching the internet. I want to do anything, some Excel work, okay, AutoCAD, 3D Studio, whatever, name it, any application that you need, okay? If that is on the program that you write, the microprocessor will perform it. Right. That means the microprocessor understands everything in the world? No, the microprocessor has, as we mentioned, instruction sets that it can understand. And it is the job of the programmer to use this instruction set to build a meaningful program for the microprocessor to execute. Okay? Right. We want to remember something, that microprocessor itself, it's a DLD design, so it only can deal with binary numbers. The binary here is used for everything. It's used for the data, the ones and zeros, exactly. It's used, the binary, the ones and zeros are used to represent the data, are used to define the instructions, are used to store the data in the memory, okay? Used in many things. And this is actually the catch. That's the one part of things that we need to learn throughout this class. How can I represent everything just in binary, okay? So this is a challenge. We wanted to see how we will face this challenge. Come on. In the operation, let's go and dig a little bit deep how the microprocessor works. 99% of the microprocessors that are being designed since 1945 have used some model called the von Neumann architecture. This model is being developed or invented by a scientist, okay, in physics called John von Neumann. So they call it by his name. What's the von Neumann model? The von Neumann model, actually, this guy is actually invented the story that we just talked about. He mentioned that in order to do processing or to build a programmable device, okay, a microprocessor, or in this slide, we call it a CPU. You know what CPU stands for? It is in the slide, Central Processing Unit. Okay. So the Central Processing Unit contains, actually, in the picture here, what are the devices that you can identify inside the CPU? Inside the CPU. What can you see inside the CPU? I see people sleeping, right? Inside the CPU, you can see ALU, and you can see control units. Okay, exactly. The CPU contains something called the control unit. You have now termed this control unit with ALU. This is what is shown in this picture. The CPU is actually taking orders. Okay, so something trigger the CPU to run. The CPU will take the data from the input device or maybe from the memory, okay, and execute them and produce them. So the von Neumann model is characterized by something very important and crucial. The CPU is not storing neither your data nor your full program, neither your full data nor your full program. So the CPU is just a brain. The microprocessor is just the brain, okay? So it actually, each time if the microprocessor or the CPU needs to perform some operation or instruction, he go, grab it from the memory, execute it, then produce its results, okay? And you go into this cycle, okay, for all the instructions that the microprocessor or the CPU can find inside for your program. Tamam? This is not the whole, the end of the, or the whole story. We will explain the story in more details in the next lecture. But we want to dig more about the, so about the hardware of the computer system and the microprocessor. If right now we identify the ALU, and we also identify something you called what? The control unit. And von Neumann, we will talk about it. The von Neumann model is saying that, or stating that, in order to achieve the programmability, you should have a program of set of instructions stored in the memory and continuous communication between the brain of your machine, of your computer system, CPU or microprocessor, and the memory is going back and forth, okay, for each and every instruction to be executed. This is what's called the von Neumann model. Agree? Make sense so far? طيب نيجي وما حدش قال اه بس انا بقول اه. طيب خير ماشي. طيب هنا بقى عايزين نقول ايه؟ عايزين دكتور علي ابتدى يلخبطنا شويه. تمام؟ the C, the control unit directs the operations of the microprocessor. Yes, the control unit is actually the manager, as we will see in a minute. Wait me a little bit and we will talk more about the control unit. Before we talk about the control unit and its job, we need first to discriminate, or actually to avoid some confusion for the students here, okay? Now we have two terms, and those two terms are used interchangeably in many of the sources. So that's why I kind of emphasize to discriminate them here. Okay, what is the difference between the CPU and the microprocessor? Okay, does anybody know? Okay, A or CPU? CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. Right. Well, microprocessor, Allah, it seems the same. Okay, so let us just resolve this problem here. CPU is more logical naming for the brain of your computer system, while the microprocessor is more hardware term. Yani when I say microprocessor, I mean the chip that contains the brain of your machine, of your computer system. This is the microprocessor. So when I say microprocessor, I usually refer to a hardware piece of hardware. The CPU is also a hardware, but actually the CPU is more of a logical term, more of a logical term. It is not part, a CPU, some people in the computer architects, the computer engineers, okay, professionally, CPU is considered to be part of the microprocessor. CPU is part of the microprocessor. The microprocessor contains many other things other than the CPU. But since the end user, do not is not experts in hardware, the end user is not expert in the hardware, so they see the microprocessor and the CPU are the same, and so do we in this class. So in this class we will not discuss the differences between the CPU and the microprocessor, because the microprocessor contains more of hardware components to make the microprocessor operation faster and more efficient, that we will not discuss it in this class. We consider this as part of the design of the microprocessor, and we shift it to the CSA class. Okay? ALU by يعني inside the microprocessor or inside the CPU, احنا اتفقنا في two devices we talked about so far اللي هم مين؟ الـ ALU والـ CU. تمام؟ على فكرة مش دول الـ two devices بس، لا احنا هنا we will identify and talk about three devices. Okay, not shown in the von Neumann model but shown in the later slides. Okay, تمام؟ يبقى الـ CPU أو الـ microprocessor from our point of view because in this class we are users to the microprocessor. We are not designers of the microprocessor. We will see the CPU, the microprocessor, as if it is a CPU. However, the CPU, the microprocessor contains more of hardware than the CPU. تمام كده؟ طيب. So, can you see this picture? Okay, this picture is more representable to what we will be discussing for the microprocessor or the CPU. If a microprocessor or the CPU is now based on the picture that we have here in slide number 19, contains actually three components, not two. Okay, the picture بتاعت عمنا von Neumann ما كانتش مبرية مين one component كان ناقص كانت مورية ايه It only shows the ALU with control units. Agree? But actually, we will be dealing with the three components, not two. ايه بقى الثيرد كومبوننت اللي باينه هنا؟ عشان بس اشوف النص صحيح ولا نايمه. معانا ولا مش معانا؟ ايوه. الريجستر اري. اوكي؟ طيب. Now we need to discriminate register. محدش يقول لي يعني ايه register. اوعى تقول لي يعني ايه register. You know what is the register. We learned register in DLD. The last lecture of DLD, chapter 6 in DLD, we build what's called the register. مش كده ولا ايه؟ صح؟ We will talk about the register. So register is actually what's a register? What's a register? Logically, register ده اسم hardware. This is a hardware. This is a technical term. But what actually the functionality of a register? يعني أي حاجة في الدنيا هي لها اسم ولها وظيفة، صح؟ Anything we learn, it has a name and it has a functionality. What is the functionality of a register? لا يا ما انت لسه بتكلميني عن الهاردوير، انت دلوقتي فصصتي لي اكتر الريجستر جوه متكون من ايه. تمام؟ عمر جاب اجابه صحيحه. يس ات از ايه؟ ات از ستارج. ات از ستارج. يبقى الريجستر ما هو الا ستارج. اوكي؟ وانا قاصد اسميه ايه؟ اسميه ستارج. ليه؟ علشان افرق ما بينه وما بين الميموري. اوكي؟ الله، هو في فرق ما بين الستورج والميموري؟ ستورج is the more general term. Okay? Any digital data that I want to store, I will store it in a storage, in a digital storage. A digital storage ID could be of different types. We will talk about them. تمام كده؟ طيب. What are the different storages that we can see in the picture here in slide 19? You can identify, ايوه, you can identify here actually how many types of storages here. How many storages? ايوه كده. فاطمة. There are three types of storage in this picture. ايه هما؟ الريجسترز inside the microprocessor. واللي سميناهم memory وجمعناهم على بعض هنا في كلاود صفرة. اوكي؟ اللي فيها ايه؟ واحدة حاجة بالاخضر والتانية بالبيربل. صح؟ واحدة منهم سميناها ايه؟ primary storage. والتانية سميناها secondary storage. يبقى this picture is actually showing three different types of storage. Okay? What the storage inside the microprocessor اسمها ايه؟ اسمها register. وليه سميناها register؟ Because it uses the exact same technology that we have used in the last chapter of DLD, Digital Logic Design. Okay, so it is using the exact same technology. It uses the exact same technology to build its hardware. Allah. So what about the other storages? Okay, here we have called something called the primary storage and something called the secondary storage. We will talk about them later on. Come on. They are all of them logically, functionally, they are storing data. In a data, you store data. Come on. So one can register, we store data. Primary storage, اللي احنا بنسميه الميموري. يبقى الميموري is my primary storage. اللي بانت فين؟ اللي بانت في الفون نيومان مين؟ مال. طيب ايه هي السكندري ستورج؟ السكندري ستورج بتضم اوكي also data storage. بس حد يديني كده example about the secondary storage. ايوه ايه الاس اس دي؟ الهارد ديسك. برافو يا هند. اوكي هارد ديسك is a secondary storage. USB is a secondary storage. Solid state disk is a secondary storage. Flash memory is a secondary storage. Okay? تمام؟ DVD, okay, CD, all of those are secondary storages. تمام؟ يبقى we have different technologies and different ways to store the data in the digital world. تمام؟ We can identify three of them. حاجة اسمها registers موجودة فين؟ inside the microprocessor. وحاجة اسمها الميموري أو بيسموها الرام. الاسم الدارج عنها في السوق. Okay. In the commercial we call it mean. We call it the RAM. RAM stands for random access memory. Okay. And we have also the secondary storage. طيب يبقى three components for the microprocessor. ALU, registers to store data, and the control unit. Before we go into this, there is something قبل ما نسهب اكتر في الهاردوير ولا نسهب اكتر في الهاردوير كنت عايز اقول الديفينيشن بتاع الوورد. اوكي مش عارف ده مناسب دلوقتي ولا لا. خلينا نكمل في الهاردوير. خلينا نرجع تاني للوورد. نكمل الهاردوير؟ طب نكمل الهاردوير خلاص ولا هزعلكم. بس فكروني نرجع للديفينيشن اوف ذا وورد يعني ايه وورد. تمام؟ خلاص نكمل في الهاردوير. يبقى let's continue in the discussion of the hardware of the microprocessor. يبقى we identified three components of the hardware inside the microprocessor. تمام؟ او سي بي يو مش هتفرق بقى معانا. تمام؟ سميناه سي بي يو سميناه microprocessor مش فارق معانا. اوكي؟ بس احنا عشان engineers بنسميه microprocessor. تمام؟ السي بي يو ده اسم دارج واسم more logical central processing unit عشان تعرف يعني السي بي يو بتعبر عن الفانكشناليتي اوف ذا microprocessor. تمام؟ ان هي central processing unit. بس المايكروبروسيسور از ذا هاردوير chip itself. تمام؟ والمايكروبروسيسور have a lot of components inside it. طيب ايه three components that we talk about today inside the microprocessor؟ اتكلمنا على two components مفهومين واضحين. مش بس مفهومين وواضحين. They are, we actually have designed them in DLD. مش كده ولا ايه؟ The first two components don't sahleen. They are very easy. They, because you know about them. Okay, what's the ALU? Arithmetic and logic unit. What's the arithmetic and logic unit? It's a group of functional units that are actually used to do, this is the real brain of the microprocessor. بيعملوا ايه؟ They are doing the arithmetic and logic operations. زي ايه الارثمتيك واللوجيك اوبريشن؟ Arithmetic operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, oring, shifting, rotating. Okay? They are doing manipulation of the bits. You provide some bits to them and they will manipulate the bits. And we build many of them in DLD chapter 4. صح؟ Agree? Make sense? Time. The second hardware component that we want to talk about the microprocessor is the registers. Also, this device is simple, easy. We know it by heart from DLD. We build it. First of all, register is a combination of sequential circuit. Combination of sequential. مين هيقول registers combination ولا sequential sequential طبعا sequential ليه درسناها في chapter 6 تمام اوكي بس anyway الريجستر ما هو الا ايه الا انه starch تمام agree make sense طيب جميل قوي اخر component بقى اللي هي new بنتعلمها النهارده وهي برضو هنكتشف ان هي مش new ليه مين the last component here is called the control unit We need to know what is a control unit. What's a control unit? Control unit is the maestro, is the manager of the microprocessor. Inside the microprocessor, I have some storage registers. I have some ALUs, arithmetic logic units, adder, subtractor, multiplier. So who will manage the operation of those? I need some units, some control units to control the microprocessor. So the control unit is actually the manager of the microprocessor that actually manage all of the operations will process that is being done inside the microprocessor. This is actually the heart of the microprocessor. من غيرها ما عنديش حاجة اسمها microprocessor. Okay? This is the most sophisticated, complicated device inside the microprocessor. This is actually what you wanted to learn how to design, not in this class, but in CSA class, Computer System Architecture class. So we will spend most of the time in the CSA class doing what? Learning how can I build a control unit to have really a microprocessor. Time to make things more clear for you. Okay? We will make a human being analogy. عشان نقرب الفكرة شوية. Okay? Your friend is giving you two numbers of 10 digits and is asking you to perform an add operation between those two digit numbers, 10 digit numbers. Agree? Make sense? Now, what you will do? You will go and take the input, layer data from your friend. Tamam? So you will give orders for him to provide to you the numbers. Did you do any calculations yet? Did you do any calculations yet? No, you just get the numbers and you put them in your memory. The memory هنا هتبقى ايه? Maybe scratch paper or the board. Okay? أنا عندي هنا الأرقامين اهو. 357, I want to add it to 921. Okay? So, your friend is asking you to do this mathematical operation to add those two numbers. So all what you have to do is to go grab a scratch paper, which in the computer system, this is your RAM. This is your memory, your volatile memory, your RAM. The RAM here عندك هي مين? هي البورد بتاعتي. البورد بتاعتي. I use my input devices, اللي هو البن, okay, ومالير, okay, in order to get the input to my memory. حطيته هنا كده في الرام. طيب عملت اي حسابات؟ لسه ما عملتش حسابات. مخي الكنترول يونت اللي عندي is managing this, okay? Taking the inputs from the input device, put it into the memory. And then I want to start the performing the mathematical operation. We'll start. I will take the first two numbers, the 7 will 1. تعمل فيهم ايه؟ I will fetch them, I will read them from my memory, okay, my RAM, اللي هي البورد بتاعتي واوديهم على فين؟ اوديهم على فين؟ اول رقمين دول 7 و1 اوديهم على فين؟ هفوتهم على مين بقى؟ ايوه كده الاي ال يو اللي هنا اللي جوه هنا في المخيخ ده ها؟ في الطاقه السوداء اللي فوق دي اروح واخد الرقمين دول واروح ادخلهم على الاي ال يو اللي عندي هنا جوه، انا عندي اي ال يو جوه هنا رسماتك لوجيك يونت هنا خلاص؟ تيك نمبر 7 ونمبر 1 يلا اي ال يو tell me what is the result of adding 1 to 7 your ALU inside your brain okay will give you the answer 8 صح okay can I keep the 8 in my mind this is hard مش كده ال easy what's the easy in order to make it very efficiently very simple اعمل ايه اعمل ايه اروح حاطط ايه احط ال 8 فين النتيجه okay I will store the result 8 back into my memory. Okay? تمام؟ الريجسترز كانت هنا جوه. Okay؟ تمبرري جوه في دماغي. Okay؟ خدت رقم 7 وخدت رقم 1 وجمعتهم وادتني النتيجه 8. Okay؟ مش عايز اجيب ال 8 في التمبرري ستورج اللي جوه في دماغي. Okay؟ هروح حاططهم فين تاني بقى؟ فين؟ في الايه؟ في الرام هنا. ايه الرام بتاعتي؟ تمام؟ حاططهم تاني في الرام. وبعدين اروح اجيب ايه؟ مين؟ النتائج اللي بعدهم، اوكي؟ الرقمين اللي بعدهم مين؟ 5 و 2، اوكي؟ put them into my brain، اوكي؟ temporary storage اللي هي الريجسترز عندي، جاي لك رقمين اسمهم كام؟ 5 و 2، 2 and 5، والاوردر اسمه ايه؟ اسمه addition، اوكي؟ so I will tell my ALU جوه هنا اقول له ايه؟ اجمع ال 5 و 2، اوكي؟ adding 2 to 5 give me the result هيروح مديني result كام؟ result 7 okay so store where انا عندي 2 registers انا عندي 2 storages في storage temporarily inside my brain okay it's small size it cannot occupy too much of that only the 2 numbers under the operation of the ALU are stored in my temporary storage in my brain okay but the full numbers I'm storing them in on my bigger memory اللي هي مين الرام تمام كده okay يبقى هنا ايه I'm dealing with 2 types of storages storage small and elementary has a small capacity okay اللي هي فين في دماغي دماغي ما تقدرش تشيل 15000 نمبر في نفس الوقت اوكي تمام تقدر تشيل رقمين بس في نفس الوقت وتقدر تديني الاوبريشن بتاعتك اوكي this is actually the purpose and the job of the register registers are temporary storage inside my brain this is my microprocessor but the microprocessor here is actually doing 2 jobs it has the ALU it has the registers It has a control unit to manage all of this operation. Your brain is your microprocessor. Okay? It gives the orders for collecting the data, okay, from the input device, putting the data into your RAM, and start fetching the data from your RAM, give it to the registers inside your microprocessor, okay, perform use the ALU to perform the add operation and produce the result. I don't want to keep the result in my registers here in the brain, so I will put them back into me, into the memory. And I will keep doing this until I finish the result, okay? Again, adding 3 to 9 will give me the result, take the numbers, send them to the registers inside my brain, send them to the ALU, ALU will do the calculation and give me the result 2 and 1. Now the result is ready for my friend on the RAM. صح؟ Agree? Make sense? Okay? If I leave the memory here in the, so the data here is in the RAM, I wanted to give it back to my friend okay so I want to use some output the input devices
provide to me the numbers, and after I do the calculation, I have to produce the output to the output device.
Maybe printing this nice result for him onto a paper, or I store it to his hard disk, or put it into his flash memory, or burn it onto a DVD, okay? Or send it to him through the email, whatever. Okay? Fine. What can you notice here? What can you notice here that my CPU, my microprocessor, my brain here is used only to perform the arithmetic and logic operation, or it should also manage the full operation from the beginning till the end? There is a manager here that manages the whole process من الأول للآخر. And this is the job of mean. This is the job of the control unit. If a control unit control all of the operations inside the microprocessor, it communicates the data between the input-output devices and the memory and the registers and the ALU. It is the maestro. It is the device that performs everything inside the machine. Okay? يبقى the most critical, okay, manager or the manager of the operation in the microprocessor, اللي هو مين ده؟ اسمه ايه؟ The manager of the microprocessor is the control unit of the microprocessor. Is actually maestro or manage or يعني do all of the operations inside me, inside the microprocessor. تمام؟ فهمنا ايه هو control unit؟ تمام؟ Are we going to design the control unit؟ لا. We will only, I will give you only an example of the control unit, a very simple example of the control unit, okay? Later on, not in this lecture. But right now, did you get the sense of what's the control unit and what it is doing in the microprocessor? Okay? Here, we just introduce the operation of the control unit. احنا فهمنا functionality بتاعت the control unit, okay? طيب, can we design the control unit? Yes, we can. Where is this? We need to do it. No. Wait until the computer system architecture class to learn how can you build a control unit of a microprocessor. Okay? Control unit design of the microprocessor is the most sophisticated thing. Okay? Building ALUs is very simple. We learn it in DLD. Building registers is simple. We build it in DLD. By the way, the control unit also is not coming out of nowhere. Okay? We learn some components that are actually the critical components of the control unit in terms, and I'm talking about in hardware terms, okay? We learn them also in DLD. Do you have any clue? I know that this is not an easy question. This is a very tough question, but maybe you can make a guess. Okay? What are the components for the, what are the basic critical components used to build the control unit in the microprocessor? Do you have any guess? لا يا هند حرام عليك. حرام عليك اما تقولي لي adder وsubtractor. الadder وsubtractor دول ايه؟ Perfect, we get a great answer هنا ساره وتمارا تمام جاوبوا اجابات زي الفل يسر also okay we learn the basic components to build a control unit also in DLD okay the control unit of the microprocessor is all based on the components that we learned in DLD اللي هم multiplexers demultiplexers and مين تاني غير المultiplexers ايه تاني اتعلمناه ايوه decoders encoders و decoders okay these are the critical components okay to build, okay, the control unit of the microprocessor. I know that maybe I attracted your appetizer. How can you do that? I'm sorry, I cannot tell you now, okay? Not even in this class, okay? We will learn all of the details of this main CSA. Inshallah, Dr. Sahib will teach us this, okay? It is too advanced to talk about this in this class. We still need to learn how these simple components that we have in our slide 19 here can interact with each other, okay, to use a microprocessor before we go and design a microprocessor. Okay, it is too early for us to design the control unit. Okay, let us learn what it takes for a control unit, or what is expected from a control unit before we go and build it. Tamam? But to cut the long story short, control unit is nothing but a group of multiplexers with decoders, maybe registers, counters, okay? All the components, there is no new inventions here. The knowledge that you get in DLD, the components that you learn in DLD are the basic blocks that we use to build the microprocessor. Okay? I cannot wrap my head on any components that new that you will be learning. Okay? We build the most basic components in DLD. Tamam? Right. Yep. Although we learned it, I think you get a motivation. You have learned it to some extent, the functionality of the control unit. Okay? We want to set some rules here. Okay? Any component has name, has hardware structure to build it, and has functionality. We explained today the functionality of the control unit. We give some hint what are the basic components to build a control unit. Details are shifted to another class, CSA class. Agree? Make sense? You get it? Any question? Okay, we left for us. خلينا نخش على الموضوع الثاني ونتكلم. We talked a little bit today, our word, مش هنساها. جزاك الله ألف خير يا يوسف. خليك ورايا لغاية لما أقولها. خليك ورايا لغاية لما أقولها، تمام؟ بس إحنا إيه؟ Let's continue the hardware. Since we already start talking about the storage, تمام؟ عندنا بقى next important critical title is the storage. Storage. تمام؟ Today we identified three types of storage. حد يقدر يسمعهم لي؟ الميموري اللي commercially بيسموهم الرامات، الرامز. صح؟ خلاص؟ خلاص من هنا رايح مش هنسميهم primary storage. هنسميها RAM. يبقى عندنا RAM. We have registers. خلاص. We have the secondary storage بقى اللي هي بتضم حاجات كتيرة. بتضم ايه؟ بتضم هارد ديسك، سوليد ستيت، فلاش ميموري، دي في دي، سي دي. اوكي؟ All of those we call them secondary storages بقى. اوكي؟ Or more permanent storage. We need to talk about the storages a little bit. We need to actually discriminate between two major storages that we will be dealing with while we are learning the microprocessor hardware. في اثنين مهمين جدا and we need to focus on them because we will deal with them significantly. هما مين؟ المين ميموري اللي هي الكوميرشال اللي بيسموها الرام، تمام؟ كوميرشال they call it الرام، and the second storage اللي اسمها ايه؟ الريجسترز. اوكي؟ سوري مش second storage، اسف، الريجسترز inside ايه؟ الريجستر. يبقى احنا عندنا المين ميموري وعندنا ايه؟ ريجسترز. But what about the secondary storage? Secondary storage is a permanent storage to store your data, okay, and it keeps them for long time. And we don't that much interested to study them because they are not really related to the operation of the microprocessor or the computer system in general. You know something? Anciently, when they first built a computer system, there is nothing called hard disk. شفت السربرايز دي؟ مفاجأة مش كده؟ Okay. The first computer system ever that have been built without secondary storage. I can build a computer system with only memory, main memory, RAM, and registers. The permanent, there wasn't something called permanent storage. That can feel برضو, بس كان اسمها ايه? They can store things on the tapes. Okay? شفتوا التيبس قبل كده? شرايط الكاسيت? حد يسمع عن شرايط الكاسيت? عن حاجة اسمها شرايط الكاسيت? طبعا دي مش في جيلكم خالص يعني. دي على جيلي انا. دي حاجة قديمة كده انقرضت. It's an ancient thing. Some called cassette tapes. Okay? So the data was being stored in some magnetic cassette tapes. تمام؟ حاجة انقرضت من زمان، تشوفوها في المتاحف دلوقتي. تمام؟ بس لو دورتوا عليها على النت هتلاقي في صور شرايط، أنا عندي منها على فكرة. عايزين؟ أبقى لسه موجودة عندي في البيت. أوكي؟ ده حاجة انقرضت كده. أوكي؟ So the storage, the permanent storage of a computer system was being stored on the tapes. أوكي؟ Magnetic tapes. أوكي؟ But it is not tightly attached to the computer system. It's detached. تمام؟ And it is not related to the operation of the microprocessor itself. Okay? يعني ال von Neumann model لما von Neumann حط المول بتاعه بتاع الكمبيوتر سيستم ما جابش سيرة ال permanent storage دي خالص. Okay? أنا كل اللي عايزه إيه؟ أنا عايز input device، أنا عايز RAM memory، main memory، أنا عايز output device. Okay? ال output device بقى ده هتستور الحاجة. You want to permanently store the data, fine. You want to produce the data and just print it out. On papers, that's also fine. تمام كده؟ Fine. يبقى the two storages that we are really interested in and we will be dealing with them extensively to understand the operation of the microprocessor اللي هما مين؟ Two types of storage. The main memory and this is located in a separated chip. وهنا بقى ايه؟ عايزين نصحى مع بعض شوية. We need to concentrate. Do you still remember this picture? Okay, the main memory or the memory here, is it in the same block of the microprocessor or outside it? It is outside it, okay? The main memory, our RAM, it is a different chip. When we go to the store to buy or to assemble your computer system, a microprocessor is a chip, IC chip, well, main memory is another chip. تمام كده؟ طيب يبقى this is the first difference between mean between the main memory and the registers. The main memory is a chip outside the microprocessor and is being connected to the compute to the microprocessor through what we call the bus, we will talk about it, in order to assemble a PC. جميل اللي اسمه الباص هنتكلم عن شغلانة الباص ده كمان تمام؟ But before we talk about the bus, we have two types of storages we want to talk about. Lomamine and main memory or registers. What are the difference between the main memory and the registers? There are three differences that we have to be able to identify for, in order for us to learn how the microprocessor is working. The differences there تتلخص في الآتي. They are can be summarized. There is different in. Can you see my? سؤال ولا إيه محمد? Memory is volatile. Permanent storage is not. طبعا أكيد. تمام? هنتكلم عن الموضوع. خلينا بس الأول. Let's focus on the two storages that are in focus now. اللي هم مين? Registers والإيه? والمين memory. تمام. What are the differences between the registers and the main memory؟ Three differences. عايزين نحطهم حلقة في ودننا. ايه هما؟ في different in design technology. When we build a storage in DLD, when we build, okay, storage in DLD, do we call it main memory؟ حد عمره سمعنا في الديجيتال لوجيك ديزاين سميناها مين ميموري؟ لا. ليه؟ Because the technology that is used to build the memory in DLD is the technology for the registers. It's using transistors, it's using logic gates. مش كده؟ Sequential circuits, what is the basic block for the register؟ اسمه ايه اللي بنستخدمه عشان نبني register؟ Register simply refresh our memory is a multi-bit storage. Okay? Register is a ايه؟ Is a multi-bit storage. مش كده ولا ايه؟ صح؟ Register is a multi-bit storage. What is the basic storage of a bit. ايوه كده عمر صاحي معانا. اسمه ايه؟ فليب فلوب. الفيفيز فاكرين الفيفيز؟ الدي فليب فلوب. اوكي؟ We use the D flip flop which is actually using NAND gates or NOR gates whatever connected back to back وبالفيدباك والفيلم اللي طلعت عندنا فيه ده بتاع شابتر 5 اوكي؟ عشان نبلد مين؟ عشان نبلد الدي فليب فلوب. One D flip-flop can build for me one storage, okay, of one bit inside a register. So the technology used to build the register is using the flip-flop technology or using the transistor technology. الله. طب ده مختلف عن المين ميموري. الله. يعني the main memory is storing also bits ones and zeros, and it is not using the flip-flop. The answer is yes. Main memory of your computer system is not using the flip-flop technology. Okay? The main memory is using other technology called SRAM. Okay? A technology of the flip-flops, we call it SRAM. A technology that's called SRAM is used to build mean registers. Right. For the main memory, I am building using a, this is for the main memory. The main memory is using a technology called DRAM to build it. And registers using technology called SRAM. What's the difference between the SRAM and the DRAM? This is actually beyond our scope. We will also defer this to the CSA class. Okay? In the CSA class, maybe at the last chapter or something, we will talk about the different technologies to build a storages, the main memory or registers. Okay? Registers عرفناها. We already learned the SRAM. Okay? Technology of SRAM. But the technology for the DRAM that is used for the main memory, okay, is different. Tamam? No, we are skipping the hardware sophisticated things in this class. Okay? يعني ايه skip the class? عايزين تسكيب الكلاس كله؟ خلاص؟ You will not learn anything. You will not do, okay, without this class, without the microprocessor class, you will not be able to go to the CSA because actually the CSA will go to the details of the hardware design, okay? And you cannot do it, okay, without even knowing what's the microprocessor and how it is working. لأ, the main memory is not using the flip-flops. You still remember, خلينا أقربها لكم شوية, okay? Do you still remember how many logic gates used to build 1D flip-flop in the registers? Do you remember how many logic gates we used to build it? How many? This is the اتنين ده اللي هو اللاتش. But when we go to the sequential, synchronous sequential عشان ابني دي فليب فلوب مش هنلاش دي فليب فلوب. على الاقل محتاج مين؟ اربعه مين؟ بالظبط كده الاجابه صح يا عبد العزيز. We need four NAND gates to build one flip flop. مش كده ولا ايه؟ You agree؟ مظبوط الاجابه صح 100%. تمام؟ Each of those NAND gates is built using okay at least four transistors. Have you taken the fundamental of electronics class or not yet? You finished fundamental of electronics? Okay, not yet. Okay, you will learn in the fundamentals of electronics how to build the logic gate. The logic gate is being built through a technology called the transistors. And to build logic gate, okay, it needs four NAND gates. That means how many transistors do you use to build one bit storage using the flip-flop technology? مين اللي قال 8؟ 8 ازاي؟ 4 ترانزستورز في كل ناند جيت، وعندي 4 ناند جيت يبقى اديني كام؟ كام ترانزستور؟ ايوه عمر قال اهو كام؟ 16. رغب كمان جاوبت بيرفكت. اوكي I need 16 transistor to build one bit storage in the register or in the SRAM technology. اوكي مش only ولا حاجه تمام 16 transistor. Do you know in order to store one bit of the DRAM how many transistors do we need؟ حتى الترانزستور ده مش انت you know from circuits في حاجه اسمها ريزيستور وفي حاجه اسمها كاباسيتور وحاجه اسمها اندكتور صح كده؟ اوكي؟ Those are the electronic components that you learned in circuit one. Okay? In order to build the digital components we need something called the transistor. You will learn the transistor في class اسمه fundamentals of electronics. So we will not go into the details of how to build a transistor. اتفقنا؟ متفقين على ده؟ Okay, so we will not learn what's a transistor. The transistor is a device. Transistor is a device. زي resistance, زي inductance, like the capacitance, okay? Called the transistor. The transistor is the basic block to build logic gates. Okay? One logic gate needs four transistors. تمام؟ طيب يبقى احنا اتفقنا. Wait me a little bit. رجعت لكم اتفقنا دلوقتي عندنا كام ترانزستور علشان نبيلد 1 فليب فلوب تو بيلد الفليب فلوب از 1 الفليب فلوب از 1 بيت ستورج. Okay, so we need 16 transistor to build one bit storage. تمام كده؟ In DRAM technology, for our main memory, we need only one transistor. That means the size of one bit storage in the registers is equivalent to 16 bit storage in the memory. So the first size here, the first difference here between the memory and the register is in a 1 to 16 in size. مظبوط تمام يبقى that's why the registers are fewer okay inside the microprocessor. Okay, they are fewer with less capacity. تمام؟ اوكي؟ طيب يجي هنا السؤال الله ايه الهبل ده؟ ليه يروحوا يبنوا ميموري ب 16 ترانزستور when they can build the memory with only one transistor. ايوه كده بيرفكت انسر محمد باشا وهند هانم جريت انسر. The difference is in speed. Okay, the SRAM technology that we use in the registers is maybe 100 times faster than the DRAM technology. Why? The DRAM use one transistor and a capacitor, and the capacitor is very slow. Okay. We will not elaborate more on this, okay? So let's just move on. But I give you some idea about why, okay, we have different types of storages. Because actually, inside the microprocessor, I want to use the logic gates to build the AND or the ALU and also the storage. So I need them to be of an equal speed, okay? Since ALU, adder, subtractor, multiplier, okay, is using the logic gates to build their logic, I need also the registers, which are bigger in size but fast. Okay. Now, since they are bigger in size, they are small in capacity. Yeah. ايه الفرق بين السايز والكاباسيتي؟ Do you know what's the difference between the size and the capacity? What's the difference between size and the capacity? شباب نمتوا مني ولا ايه؟ What is the difference between the size and the capacity? Can you discriminate between size and the capacity? Okay, size is the amount of space. That means I can tell you here, in this 1 centimeter or 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter, this is the size. Okay, if you limit the size to some size, okay, I want to use this size to store some capacity of data. Okay, if I use the exact same size and I use the register technology, I may fit here maybe 100 bits. For the exact same size, if I used the DRAM technology for the main memory, I may store here 10,000 bits. Okay, so in the main memory, I can pack more storage, okay, in a smaller size. يبقى صح إجابة محمد exactly perfect, okay. So the difference, nothing comes for free, nothing comes for free, okay. The huge gap between the speed of a register and the speed of the main memory has a disadvantage, which is the capacity. If I give you a 10 millimeter space for your storage, okay, if you occupy this space by register, you will have a few number of bits to be stored. But at the same space, I can pack more and more data, okay? By the way, we have the exact same difference here between let me just jump here to slide 28. We have the same thing. Okay, so SRAM has, it is faster in speed, faster, but it occupies big size, means less capacity. In DRAM,
and memory is slower, but okay, so it is slower and smaller in size, so it has a more high capacity. You get the idea? Is this clear? Okay, let us jump by what about the secondary storage? It is the exact same trend. Okay, if I am comparing my main memory to my hard disk, what is the capacity of your main memory in the laptop that you are using right now to hear my discussion? What is the capacity of your memory? Huh? جميل، إجابة حلوة أوي. 8 جيجا مش كده؟ 16 جيج. لو المكنة بتاعتك يعني مقطعة الدنيا وجايب أحدث حاجة نزلت في السوق هتبقى كام؟ 32 جيجا بايت مش كده؟ تمام؟ احنا لسه ما كملناش واتس ذا بايت دي، هنقولها إن شاء الله المرة الجاية، ما لحقناش النهاردة. صح؟ طيب، what is the size of your hard disk؟ I'm not the size, the capacity. خلاص؟ مش عايزين نقول كلمة size تاني. What's the capacity of your تمام 1 تيرا 2 تيرا اوكي 5 تيرا so the exact same gap in speed and in capacity that do exist between the storage of the registers inside the microprocessor repeated again between the main memory and the secondary storage. In the secondary storage, I can pack much more number of bits in a much smaller size. So I can have a large capacity. Okay? But I am 1,000 times slower than the registers. Okay, so nothing comes for free. So I gain in capacity, I lose in speed. Okay, طيب. What is the technology that is used? وهقفل بقى علشان احنا we are start exceeding our time. تمام؟ We will continue next time. What is the technology that is used for the secondary storage? Okay, is it SRAM? لا. Is it DRAM? No, it is, as some of you said, right now, neither nor. It's using completely different technology. It's either magnetic tapes or magnetic devices or SSD cards or optical, okay? So these technologies to store the data are much more slower, are hundreds and thousand times slower than the transistor technology. Okay, so they can pack more data on them, but you will have slower speed. Okay, this is the one difference between me and my primary storage in the main memory and the secondary storage. The other difference you already mentioned it. It is very clear. اللي هي مين بقى ال volatility of the data. Okay, تمام. Data is in your hard disk. In your flash memory, in your DVD, are there volatile or non-volatile? They are non-volatile. That means when you store something and you switch off the power, the data will remain there. Okay? This is not the case in neither the main memory nor the registers. Both registers and main memory, since they are using whether SRAM or DRAM technology, the transistor technology, these devices cannot work without electricity. That means if you lose electricity, the data is lost. مخك اتمسح. زيك بالظبط كده لما ايه؟ لما تنام. اوكي؟ كل الحسبة اللي كنت بتعملها ديت خلاص اتنست. Agree? Makes sense? Okay. So in our brain here we have some volatile memory and some permanent memory. Please put the microprocessor in your permanent memory,
not in your volatile memory عشان الامتحان. ماشي؟ Okay. So it's already 4:55. I will not take more of your time. Thanks a lot. And we will continue next time to discuss. The first thing that we will start with is what is a word and what's the size of the word and the bit sizes and how to pack the data, inshallah, in the next lecture. Okay? I hope that you enjoyed our talk today. You enjoyed the lecture and wish you, inshallah, the best of luck and see you, inshallah, on Tuesday. Thanks a lot for all, and this session is recorded, and I will post the video, inshallah, today. Thank you for all, and I wish you the best of luck. Thank you, Shabab. I wish it always will be good and insightful and fruitful for you. The last video is posted and I already sent, where is it, the location.